We have a very, very tragic scene that we're working here in South Jackson. Jackson police officers were called to 3950 Bougier to assist the U.S. Marshals. They have been looking for an individual wanted out of Louisiana, Mr. Callahan. After a short pursuit, they made contact with him and he's now in custody. As you know, an Amber Alert was issued for two young children that were supposedly with him. Mr. Callahan is also a suspect in a homicide that happened in Tangipahoa Parish, Louisiana. Upon a search of the area by Jackson police officers, they located a deceased child in the woods. We suspect that to be one of the children that he had in his possession that he had illegally taken away from Tangipahoa Parish in Louisiana. One of the child, the six-year-old, my understanding, has been taken to the hospital to receive treatment, but my understanding, the four-year-old is deceased in the woods. We're still trying to determine the manner of death, but we have a very active scene here right now, very traumatic scene, very tragic scene, the death of a four-year-old child, but the suspect is in custody. I want to thank all of the many, many responding agencies here right now, the U.S. Marshals, the Jackson FBI, NBI, Hayes County Sheriff's Department, Rankin County Sheriff's Department, Byram Police Department, and Tangipahoa Parish who are here on scene as well. We ask that the public, if you know about anything that has been happening here or transpiring on Bougier, please contact the Jackson Police Department at 601-960-1234 or Crime Stopper 601-355-TIPS. Based on the crime scene that we've observed here today, we have contacted NBI's Human Trafficking Division along with Hayes County's Human Trafficking Division. We also have our Juvenile Division on scene because based on the crime scene, what it looks like, this may be a location where there has been some human trafficking done. We see cages, small animal cages. It's very, very disturbing to me as a police chief and as a father to witness and see what I just saw. So again, we ask for your prayers and support, and anybody who has any information about what happened here today, please contact the Jackson Police Department, the U.S. Marshals, or Jackson FBI.
Chief, can you tell us the name of this individual? You mentioned a Callahan. Talk to us about who actually took this individual into custody and where was he taken into custody.
His name is Daniel Callahan, white male. Daniel Callahan, white male. He was taken in custody at this location on this street in the wooded area by the U.S. Marshals, along with assistance from the Jackson Police Department. As I stated, one of our officers actually found the deceased child in the woods.
And again, you don't know whether she was shot or killed by hand.
Cannot determine the manner of death. Actually saw her myself. Again, it's very traumatic to see that. You never want to see anybody lose their life, especially a young baby, a child. So we can't determine until we process the scene as to the manner of death. And of course, that will come with the medical exam and of course, the Hayes County coroner.
Do you have a spelling on his name?
Is it age, possibly?
Daniel, D-A-N-I-E-L. Callahan, C-A-L-L-I-H-A-N, date of birth, 9-13-1987. The vehicle that he fled Louisiana in has been discovered, a black Chrysler 200 at the rear of this location on Bougier. I want to thank the Byron PD and their excellent technology because my understanding, that vehicle pinged on one of the LPRs in the area, and that's when they reached out to Tangipahoa, and they responded here to the metro area, and it's just so sad that it ended this way, with this baby, this child losing their life here.
Clearly, Chief, a lot of questions to be answered, but this abduction after the apparent death of this woman happened some 2 hours south of Jackson in Laranja. Do we have any indication of whether this individual knew people in this area?
We do not know. That's my question. Why Jackson? Why are you here? Why did you bring these children here? Why did you take this child's life here in Jackson? A lot of questions to be answered. And as you know, this has been a very wide crime effort. You know, it started down in Louisiana. That's why you have so many agencies here on scene. Of course, we're going to work with all of our federal partners, as we do all the time, FBI, U.S. Marshals. And like I said, Hinds County is on scene. NBI is a very active scene. And we don't know if there's other children in the woods. We don't know if there's other remains in the woods. We don't know. But we're going to find out. And we're asking again for any information from the public to call the Jackson Police Department.
And this four-year-old girl was in the woods behind the house, or was just a...
In the woods behind the house, probably about 30, 40 yards into the woods.
And again, you're talking about the suspicion of human trafficking. It sounds like this, for lack of a better word, it sounds like this individual knew where he was.
Do not know. I don't know. I can't speak for him, but I can say that we're going to work this crime scene with a scalpel. We're going to work it with a scalpel, not a sledgehammer. It's going to take a long time to process it. That's why we have so many agencies here on scene, so much technology here on scene, because this individual has used this location as a location to traffic children and abduct children. We want to make sure we have that evidence to make sure him and whomever else is prosecuted for this heinous, heinous, terrible act.
Chief, I heard here on the street that these two girls were buried alive in a hole. Can you give any information?
That's not true. There was a area back there, kind of a area that was below the regular area. It was below where we were standing, but they were not buried. They were not covered up. So sad, tragic, either way. I think that he was trying to, once he realized that law enforcement knew where he was or had his proximity, that he tried to do away with the children by taking them into the woods, into that area. Thank God that at least one of the children survived. My understanding, the grandparents are en route to Jackson, Mississippi to see about that baby. But unfortunately, a horrible scene to see this child lose her life here in South Jackson today.
The younger child was found in the vicinity of the deceased child?
Yes.
Really?
Yes, in the same area, probably within, you know, 5 to 10 yards.
Uninjured?
It has suffered injuries. That's why the child has been taken to the hospital.
What kind of injuries?
I can't. I have not seen that child. But I know that we do have one that's deceased to die from her injuries.
And Chief, for you to have to lay your eyes on this four-year-old child lying there on the ground dead, just give us your reaction.
Horrible, horrible, tragic situation. You don't want to see that as a police chief. You don't want to see that as a father, to see this baby on the ground that has lost her life. This is an innocent four-year-old child. That's no longer with us because of the actions of a coward who took this child from her family, who killed their mother supposedly, and brought these children to Jackson, Mississippi, and took this child's life. So it's horrible, it's tragic, it's traumatic, even for my officers to see this. It's traumatic. We didn't come to work to see this today. Nor would we wish this upon anybody. So I want the citizens of Jackson to keep us uplifted, and the family of this poor child uplifted in prayer.